Hi, everyone. He's been the Hurricanes' number one fan since 1997. His antics and devotion to the Canes never fails to make him a fan favorite. Twister's tireless work ethic is second to none as well, and he's always willing to support a good cause, as is the man behind the mask, as we find out on Hurricane Watch with Daryl Rummelt.
He's been exciting fans and antagonizing the opposition since he first blew into town in 1997. You may know him as Twister, the Tasmanian devil from Hobart, Tasmania. When he pulls on the fur legs, the hockey pants, the jersey, and of course the trademark face, Fernando Reyes is transformed into Twister.
I do it for the fans, for the kids mostly. I have two kids myself. I love seeing them smile, so I mean, putting on the Twister costume and bringing smiles to all the Lethbridge kids and all the, you know, everybody that's coming to the games, I just love it.
Beneath this tough exterior lies a true soft spot. Reyes has seen countless battles on the ice as Twister, but they're nothing compared to the off-ice fights.
I've lost friends, countless family members to all different types of cancers. I wear this with pride, it's the only way that I can kind of help out.
Reyes donates all of the money he makes as Twister to the Alberta Cancer Society's Ride to Conquer Cancer, a two-day cycling event that helps raise money for cutting-edge research and care. It's a dream job for Reyes, one he landed on a dare, answering an online job posting at the request of his friends. He says it's been as rewarding as it's been fun, and he hopes to continue playing the role next season.
I can just hide myself and be Twister. I mean, crazy, fun-loving, heckling, getting in fans' faces, heckling the other players, everything like that. I just love it, everything about it.
Twister, Tasmanian for troublemaker, and now humanitarian. Loosely translated, of course.
Hurricane Watch, sponsored by Lialta Building Supplies, for all your home building and renovating needs.
And if you'd like to help Fernando, a.k.a. Twister, reach his fundraising goal for the Ride to Conquer Cancer, go online to conquercancer.ca. Full instructions are also posted on our CTV Facebook site. The Calgary Flames stumbled again last night, this time down in Phoenix. Head coach Bob Hartley decided to give the recently called up Danny Taylor his first NHL start. And welcome to the big leagues, Danny Bye. Coyotes attack, and Keith Yandle scored 41 seconds into the game after Taylor mishandled the puck behind the Flames' net. 1-0 Phoenix just like that. Later in the period, Tim Jackman and Paul Bissonnette tangle. A few decent blows are landed. That was the only other scoring in the opening period. Here's a good chance for the Coyotes in the second period. Martin Hanzel to Yandle and blocker. Taylor made the blocker stop. Taylor had settled in, it seemed, and it was still 1-0 after 40 minutes of action in Phoenix. But that all changed quickly in the final frame. 30 seconds into the third, Michael Boddicker poked the puck between Taylor's pads, a bad goal, 2-0 Phoenix. You can see how this transpired quite clearly on the replay. Calgary was unable to get any traction after that. Shot from the point, Antoine Vermette cleaned up in front. What a battle. Taylor didn't have a chance on that one. 3-0 for the home team on Vermette's fourth of the year. Late in the game, former Flame David Moss dropped it for Rafi Torres, and that's another shaky goal allowed by Taylor. Flames are shut out for the first time this season. Mike Smith gets his third shutout of the season. 4-0 was the final score. Flames win in Dallas. Sunday, lose in the desert. Last night, they are at home to LA tomorrow. Minnesota Wild right winger and Tabor native Devin Setoguchi has been fined by the NHL for a high-sticking penalty that leveled Detroit defenseman Kyle Quincy on the weekend. The league announced today that Setoguchi was docked $8,108.11, the maximum amount allowed under the collective bargaining agreement. The incident occurred in the second period of the Wild's win Sunday over the Red Wings. Setoguchi was given a double minor for hitting Quincy in the face with his stick as they collided near mid-ice. As a first-time offender, the most Setoguchi could have been fined was $10,000 or one half of his daily salary, whichever was less. Minnesota Wild, by the way, Daryl Rummelt's favorite NHL team.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I did not know that.
Big
and
Wild
I thought
fan.
I knew most things about...
Big Wild fan coming to town to watch the Flames on Saturday.
Mm.
Yeah, we'll be going to the game together.
Are you?
Yep.
And nobody invited me.
Nope, only got two tickets.
All right, well, better luck next time for me.